Okay, guys, so I'm here preview a co-main event for UFC 158. Carl Connick versus Johnny Hendricks. Now, the key to victory for Carl Connick is to keep this fight under standing up. He does not want to deal with the wrestling of Johnny Hendricks. I know you may be saying, but Johnny Hendricks has a powerful left hook. But for Johnny Hendricks in the stand-up game, his left hook is all he has. His powerful hand is all he has. So what Carl Connick needs to do is use those leg kicks, tap those legs down, use an occasional jab to keep the distance, and when he wants to go in, throw a jumping knee. Do that on occasion, but the key for him is keeping range, use the leg kick and the jab to keep Johnny Hendricks from coming in for either a left hook or a takedown. I believe the only way that Carl Connick wins this fight is if it goes 3 rounds and if he keeps his distance and attacks from his range. Now for Johnny Hendricks, it's obvious. I say take it to the ground because Carl Connick has more tools than Johnny Hendricks does on the feet. Take it to the ground. Follow a similar game plan that GSP did. Apply some ground and pound. And ultimately, if you apply some ground and pound, you will hurt Carl Connick. Battling a bag and you might finish him. Now, who I think is going to win? I'm kind of leaning towards Carl Connick. Because in his recent fight, besides Josh Koscheck, Johnny Hendricks has fallen too much in love with his left hook, and I think that's going to hurt him. He's going to look for that left hook, and I think Carl Connick is going to keep his range and use that jab and that kick to his advantage and win by decision. That will leave GSP with no opponent, I believe, unless they decide to do the winner of Jake Allenberg versus Neymar Court, which I don't think. So that leaves GSP either with the option to fight somebody like Anderson Silva after his Chris Weidman fight. And maybe if you want to fight somebody like Benson Henderson, you can do that also. That's it for this preview, guys. Peace.